Welcome to sunny Winter Haven, Florida. I'm Lane Dog Bowers, and this could possibly be the best day ever. And the forecast for tomorrow is 1,000,006 times better. All right, today, I always say short. I don't know. Hopefully I can make it short. But I'm going to talk to you guys about barefooting, mentorship, and extreme health. You know, one thing that I've had the great privilege of doing is I've been able to help some amazing people. Most of you guys know Banana George Blair, helped him barefoot into his 90s. A lot of you guys have seen Dick Grant, who's a client of mine who started barefooting when he was 70, and now he's 86 and barefooting, and he's featured in an Advil commercial, which is awesome. And another guy, the amazing Mike Monkford, I call him. And he's an amazing guy, a war veteran, a guy who's, you know, suffered a lot, and what a comeback. And it started thinking, it started getting me to think, as I have been fortunate to be mentored by some amazing people in my life, not only with barefooting, but in lots of things. And I really believe in mentorship. I want to read you guys a quote. This is actually out of my buddy, The Willing Warrior. It's a great book if you guys ever get it. It's my buddy Joe Stump. He's an awesome guy. He's in the real estate industry, but his stuff is super good. And he's talking about mentoring and the mentor spirit. And he says, the term mentor comes from Greek mythology. Mentor, who is a friend of Odysseus, was trusted with the education of Odysseus' son, Telemachus. Ever since, mentor's name has echoed through history as an affirmation of an experienced person helping a less experienced person to learn and grow. And I am such a huge believer in that, that I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about that. It's about barefoot. You know, what I've done in my barefooting as far as my career in helping others is I really focused on fine-tuned on showing people how to water ski, wakeboard, barefoot, especially barefoot. It's super slow speeds and without falling. And I love helping people. A lot of times people later in life are like, you know, they see some of the videos and they're like, man, that would be a dream. I mean, I'd love to do that. But I mean, do you think I could do that? I mean, I'm a lot older now and, you know, and I've got these, you know, physical problems and I get tons of people asking me too. They've asked me ever since I've been in business, email after email of people saying, you know, hey, what can I do to get in shape for barefoot? Or like, what should I be doing specifically for barefoot? And I want to talk a little bit about that as well. But, you know, one thing I believe in is set your goals high, set goals that motivate you, set goals that like push you beyond, like get you so excited that you can't wait to get up in the morning. You know what I mean? That's something, you know, that I lost for a while, but you know, it's, I'm real excited to have it back again. And, you know, I want to share with you guys that, you know, it's one of the things that's always bugged me is I end up getting, you know, pretty close to a lot of my clients, because it's, you know, it's a relationship business. And even if it's not one-on-one lessons, I get really close to these people and I end up hearing about all their problems. And it's unbelievable these days how much health affects the quality of our lives. Let's face it. If you want to barefoot or enjoy water skiing and being on the water till late in life, I mean, that is a huge struggle. And I saw an interesting, this isn't where I was going to go with this, but I saw a pretty cool article come out about the health benefits and exercise, benefits of water skiing, you know, wakeboard and slalom, barefoot and everything. And it kind of was talking about it as if it gets you in shape. I have always told people that, and this will upset some of you, that barefooting, like for my barefoot crowd, barefooting does not get you in shape. All right. That you're silly to think that it does get, there's not enough workout in bear. Is it incredibly demanding? Yes, especially as you get up into the higher ranks. I mean, for a while there, I used to wear a heart rate monitor because I wanted to find out, what happens while I'm skiing? Because a lot of times we're only, unless you're doing endurance runs or something like that, you got a, like in a tournament, you got a start, a 15 second run, it's over. So we're talking what? At the very most, 25 seconds or something for a barefoot run. You know, how much, but it's like a sprint and there is a lot going on there. But when I wore that heart rate monitor, it was interesting. If I was just going out for a casual run, the heart rate would, it would go up, maybe into, I can't even remember, like 120, 130. But if I was doing like tournament type stuff, my heart rate would get unbelievably higher for that brief period of time because, you're dealing with danger, with speed, and you are putting out explosive power. So, at one point, the Olympic Training Center, and I don't even remember what year this was. I don't know if any of the people out there that'll see this will know, but the Olympic Training Center approached USA Water Ski and they said, hey, we want to get some of your top skiers out there and we want to put them through our testing here in Colorado. And we want to see where they fit as athletes. What, because we know they're not endurance athletes. They're not running long races. We kind of think they're going to be more like, I think it was speed skating, they thought, because of explosiveness, power. And so they took us there and they put us through some amazing tests. And one of them, and first of all, I don't do well in the past at altitude. So that's a struggle, being at mile high and oxygen deprivation stuff, the experience there. It's like if some of you that live in the mountains come to Florida here and you experience 100% humidity at 95 degrees, it's like, it's tough to get used to. Same thing with going to altitude. But we learned that they put us through this test called a Wingate test. And the Wingate test, they get us on a bike, and it doesn't sound like anything. You're doing a 10-second sprint. No, maybe I think it was 20. It might have been 20 or 30-second sprint. It was kind of like an assault bike, but it wasn't an assault bike because back then it was a little different. And you were hooked up with heart rate monitoring your blood work. I mean, you are hooked up to almost anything, oxygen and everything. And they have you do, I believe it was 20 or 30 seconds all out effort on the bike with I think it was either a 30 second break. Yeah, I think it was a 30 second break. And then they do that, they repeat that. And the next one all out for 20 to 30 seconds. And what they do is they increase the resistance so that it was harder as you got tired. It was actually more strength needed to do the same all-out effort while you're tired. And then again, another rest. And we did that 5 times. And they said, listen, most of you won't get to the 5th round. You'll probably get most of you will finish at 3 rounds. Some of you will finish 5. None of you will be – if you can walk when you get off this bike, you haven't done it right. Because you literally won't be able to walk. And it's hard to believe in such a short period of time. But anyway, bottom line, is what we learned at that is a lot about what our engine could put out, you know what I mean? What we put out. And it was very unusual, but some great findings there. And I ended up being on the floor. Almost everybody, I think everybody threw up. So you literally were helped off the bike where you almost immediately threw up. And then they lay you down on the ground. They try and walk you a little bit, lay you down on the ground. Then they start drawing blood from you. And I did that. Everybody of all the rest of the water skiers were gone and out of the building. And I'm still laying down on the ground for at least 45 minutes, unable to function and get myself back together. And they were miffed at why I was. Every time they sat me up for 45 minutes, I would start dry heaving and throwing up or whatever. And then they started drawing blood and they found out something unusual. They said, you have the highest lactic acid in your system that we have ever tested at the Olympic Training Center. And for many, many years, I never understood what that was. But basically for the engine that I brought to the Olympic Training Center where I was at conditioning wise, I did do a good job of giving it everything I had. But lactic acid is kind of an indicator of how well you recover. It's not a good thing. It wasn't really, I thought it was kind of a cool badge for a while, but it's not really a good thing. I mean, if you have no lactic acid produced, you could immediately start up and start working out again. That would be a healthier athlete. So I always wondered what that was, but for much of my life, after intense working out, I had my muscles hurt like they were gonna break. They hurt so bad. Well, this is kind of all leading me into how do I help you guys? You know, because for years, I basically have focused on helping people barefoot as safely as possible without getting hurt and keep advancing and moving and enjoying it. And the, you know, one of the great things is seeing people do it into their 90s. That's crazy. Who's going to be our first person healthy enough to go to 100 years old? You know, it's crazy. And Dick Grant, I've said before, I think he's, you know, not to compare, I'm not throwing stones, but I think Dick Grant might be healthier at 86 years old than for sure than Banana George was. I mean, because Dick Grant can go play golf during the day. And I mean, he works out, you know, easily, but all day long. And then not all day long, but he golfs and works out. He's doing it right. But, you know, it's amazing because I've been in this business for like 25 years, I end up seeing people, they tell me their stories, you know what I mean? And so you end up hearing about people getting cancer, getting autoimmune diseases, horrible things happening to them. You know, in 30 years of doing one little teeny world like barefooting, you just get to see all that stuff. And I've never, ever been able to offer solution to those people. I'd say, hey, you know what, I can pray for you, and I will do that, and I believe in the power of that. And I've always felt my job was not just to help people in their barefooting, but if I had the opportunity, I wanted to help them in other areas of their life. I felt like if I didn't get to that point where I could motivate them and encourage them, and hey there, Garrett, great to see you guys, hey Carlos, hey Chris, hey Dave, you know, if I don't get to the point where I can motivate someone or try and make their life a little better, it almost hurts. I feel like I haven't done my job. I'm fine with just helping you with your barefooting. But honestly, there's something in my gut that just doesn't sit right. It's like I know that I got a higher purpose than I want to help you with your barefoot. I want you to get your barefoot in miracle. But what I really want you to go away with is feeling better about yourself and taking your life to the next level. So when you leave, that you impact others. I've always said that you have a story that needs to be told that others only want to hear it from you. You know what I mean? Like Gary, hey, Rusty, good to hear from you, buddy. You know, Rusty, you got a story that people want to hear. You're the story that's developing in you. The story that's developing my buddy Gary's got an amazing story of what he's been through. And there are people, they don't want to hear it from me. Don't think that like I'm the solution. You're the solution. And so anyway, I believe everybody's got a story to tell that others want to hear, and they'll only hear it from you. Okay. So, I mean, that's what I honestly believe. So the thing in the past is I've offered a little bit of tips on health, on working out. I am not an expert at working out, even though I love CrossFit. I do CrossFit. I've done really, you know, pretty well for an older dude and in CrossFit. And I'm passionate about helping anybody who wants to do the CrossFit. The reason I love it is just because it improves your health and in so many ways. But what the footer's edge now is getting on a new mission. I've got some new products I'm so excited about that are going to dramatically help people who want to be helped. I, for the first time ever, am going to be able to help people with the most difficult problems. And let me give you an example of some of the things that I've been through. So first of all, I've got to say, you know, this, I am not a doctor. I am not a specialist really in fitness. I'm not a nutritionist, okay? What else am I not? I'm pretty much not anything except a guy who knows a lot about barefooting and that kind of stuff. But I've learned a lot of life hacks that have really helped me. And I feel like I got to get it off my chest and help the people that I can help. And I'm going to, you know, one thing I thought about doing here is I want to, for those of you who take the time to listen to this and some, whoever gets this far, I want to offer to you, and I don't know how many people I can help do this, but I want to start doing some mentorship, and I'm going to do a, I mean, I'm not saying it's, I don't know how long it's going to be and for what, but I want to help you with the challenges that you have that you need help with, regard if it's health, fitness, whatever. Here's what I'm getting at. If you want to barefoot when you're 90 to 100 years old, you better, there's going to be some massive challenges to even walking when you're 90 to 100 years old. There's some massive challenges just to be breathing till you're 90, 100 years old. So, for instance, not even a year ago, I had so many problems culminating. Most of you don't know because, like, I'll post stuff on Facebook, I'll post barefoot videos, and I post, you know, these crazy workouts and things that I'm doing. And a lot of people don't, have not realized the health challenges, only a small handful that I've gone through. But let me give you a list of the things that I'm not an expert in, but that I solved. And I feel super good about helping others. For instance, I am not a psychiatrist. If you have a problem with depression, seek professional help. But let me tell you what happened to me. And this is, I don't think I've ever shared this, for sure not live, but I feel like I gotta share this, is for 7 years, I suffered extreme depression all the way up until probably 9 months ago, 8 months ago, somewhere in there. And for seven, we had, everybody has their own challenges, right? Well, even though I'm a positive guy, even though I always look for the best, I found myself waking up so depressed, so the weight, the darkness was so real that it was shutting my life down. And I even went, my own pastor told me, he said, Lane, you need to get help and do not be afraid to take the meds to help you with depression. And godly man, 100% correct. And I'm not talking, please, I am not a medical professional. So I'm not telling you to do what I did, but I did find some things that helped me get out of that. And 7 years of depression ended this last year. In addition to all that, I ended up having multiple diagnoses, very bad, including now for 15 years, I've had this incurable liver disease. So let's call that an autoimmune disease, because there's so many people with autoimmune diseases and challenges. They said it's incurable liver disease. I will need a liver transplant. They told me 9 months ago when I was having so many problems culminating. It seems like, I don't know if in your 50s, but maybe even people younger, they get, it's just like it hits you like a wave, one bad thing after another. That was my epiphany moment, is I was getting hit. I had depression. On top of that, now they found a spot in my esophagus that they were extremely worried about. My liver disease had progressed, and they were telling me, check into the Shands Medical Hospital because you need to get on a liver transplant list. And I'm sitting here, I'm doing CrossFit. I'm like, are you flipping kidding me? I mean, there's no way. On top of it, colitis, other challenges, all right? All these things are coming at me, and all I could think of is, you gotta be kidding me. I gotta be in better health than this overweight doctor who's telling me. But the fact is, it remained. I went, started going through all these procedures, and in my head, just the same way I think for barefooting, I think for the rest of my life. And I started thinking, there has gotta be a way for me to get out of this problem. How am I gonna deal with 10 horrible problems at the same time? I mean, I'm going to become a full-time patient if I check into the Shands, get on the liver transplant list, get the colitis deal with. I mean, I'm supposed to see like 4 different experts to help me. My sister had just passed away from cancer, which was my younger sister, horrible. And it really shook up our family. So of course I'm shook up. It's like, are you kidding me? Like, how many bad things go wrong at the same time? What's unbelievable is, and I'm not going to say the how right now, what I'm saying is these things that I'm dealing with, I am not a doctor. I am not a psychologist. I am not really a motivational expert, although some people think I am, but I'm not. I mean, I'm just a guy with a lot of enthusiasm, right? But this list of problems, anybody who's had, oh, I forgot to mention sleep disorder. I had not slept through the night in probably that same amount of time that I had depression. And I have tons of friends addicted to sleeping pills and horrible parts. So I hate medication. I hate take it. I'm not saying don't do it, but I'm just saying I am against that. That industry bugs me to no end, because it's like they're putting a flamethrower in your kitchen to get rid of cockroaches, and they're going to flame the whole kitchen, and then it doesn't. It's like it's madness how what happens, the side effects and everything. So I started thinking, what solution can I have for all of these problems all at once? Because I don't know if you guys think this way, but let me know if you guys believe this, but don't you guys believe in your heart that your body was literally meant to fix itself? I have always believed that. I'm like, your body is meant, God made your body to fix itself. What happened? How could I possibly be working out this hard? I think I'm eating pretty healthy, although I wasn't. But how could I get to this point where, you know, I've got all these problems. I seem to be living healthy. There's got to be a solution for it. Thank the Lord he led me to the right solution, and a relatively simple solution. I forgot to mention another challenge. My knees were awesome. My entire barefoot career. I then had a knee problem. I was working on a side slide 360, which I never was able to show anybody, but I'd been working on the side slide 360, really cool trick. I caught and tripped, hurt my knee. I mean, it crushed it. And I'd never had a knee problem, so I didn't even think I had a knee problem. So anyway, on top of that list of things, my right meniscus, and this is not like I think it happened. I'm talking about MRI diagnosed, right meniscus torn both directions. And then later on in CrossFit, I had a tear in my left meniscus. I also, you can see a pattern here. I don't trust medicine too much, even though I know they're doing the right thing. I know they're passionate about helping people. So I'm not against doctors, but I also couldn't get a doctor to tell me that if he did the meniscus surgery, that I would have my knee flexibility back, that I would be out of pain. They really couldn't tell you that. They could say, hey, we know what it is. There's a little tear. We're going to clip it off. That's going to clean it up. So am I going to be able to run again, for instance? Well, a really cool thing happened. I'm excited about, like, yes, I am going on forever. Sorry, guys, but I'm just going to get this out. So, yeah, I haven't been able to run for a decade, probably. My knees just had hurt too much. I can do a ton of other stuff. I can do almost anything else. A surprising weighted lunges around a parking lot, box jumps, double unders, all sorts of stuff. But my knees, they hurt way, way too much when I run. Yesterday was really cool because I'm afraid to run. I'll be honest with you. I mean, that problem's not solved, but yesterday, I have a studly Zane, my 13-year-old son, and he and I did a workout together where there were 200-meter sprints after doing, you know, a bunch of other stuff. And so we had to run as a team together. And I thought, you know what? I want to run that. You know, it was a bunch of 200s, but I was like, I want to run that. And I had the wrong shoes. I had these shoes with no padding in or anything. Yesterday I ran. My son even said to me, he goes, I was trying to figure out how are you running that fast? You know, that's what Zane said to me, which made me feel real good. Cause he's pretty fast. And I kept up with him pretty good. And he was surprised that I could run that fast, but that's another thing. No doctor could tell me. They said, basically, you know, your meniscus, your in your knees, they're worn down. There's not a lot of material to work with. So even if we cut off the screwed up pieces, we can't guarantee your knees can fix. Anyway, all of these things, amazingly, by God's grace, I found my way through a solution. I found a solution to help me with all of it. And man, I'm going to start doing more and more videos about what I did and how I did it. But what I was thinking of doing is I'd love to get this information together and kind of package it and help people. But in the meantime, any of you guys out there, and I'm going to put, this will be out. It doesn't matter how many people here are on the thing, and God bless you guys all for being on here. There's going to be tons of other people watching, obviously, for a long time. That's how videos work. They're like planting a little oak tree. But if you want help, and you've got either a medical problem, even a barefoot problem, whatever you got, if you want some of my kind of life hacks that I've learned, because you know what? Again, I'm not an expert, but how come I'm able to find things that doctors say are impossible? A doctor said my liver would have to be cut in half. If I could find a donor liver, and if it didn't get rejected, that's their cure for fixing my liver. I could die doing that, let alone die before I even get to that stage. How am I was able to turn my liver disease, which is measured, by the way, by, it's not a guess, liver enzymes. And my liver enzymes have gone through the roof. What normal liver enzymes, mine are 5 and 10 times elevated, like off the charts scary. Every year it's a horrible time. I dread getting my liver enzymes checked. But I found the solution. I found a way to kind of turn it around and get healthy. And my doctors freaked out when they read my last blood work. What are you doing? Is it the CrossFit? Is it the other thing? It's a bunch of things. But those are the things I want to share. And I'm, you know what? Anybody who wants, I don't know how much of it I can handle. And I'll just be honest if I can't. But if you've got a health concern, if you've got even just a simple barefoot problem or trying to get through, I'm going to start making the footer's edge. We are going to start helping people get healthier, living longer. My goal, I want you to be the first barefooter to make it to 100 years old. But you know what's crazy? Is I'm 55 right now. I am stronger, lighter, leaner, healthier in every conceivable way. I mean, granted, yes, my knees, you know, when I was 25, my knees didn't bother me a bit and I could run like the wind. Okay. So yeah. Okay. I don't want to exaggerate, but it's ridiculous at age 55, I'm healthier. I could kick my 25-year-old butt if I met myself. How is that possible? So I'm kind of a walking miracle of things that by God's grace and the right people coming into my life, have helped me get to that. So I want to start doing that. And I'd love to kind of write a book and put, or an ebook and put it all together. But I think what I want to do first is I want to get some real world experience. So if you have got something that you want help with, you know, so you can, that's keeping you maybe from barefoot. Cause I talk to people all the time and they're like, even people in their 40s, they're like, oh, I barefoot, but I'm 40 now. And you know, there's no way I could barefoot anymore. I'm like, are you kidding me? It's like, why roll over? Like, it doesn't make sense. You guys, we got to pull ourselves out of these lies. We're getting lied to about food. We're getting lied to about drugs. We're getting lied to about sugar. I was addicted to Diet Coke. I drank 16 Diet Cokes a day for 20 years. I mean, it's insane. I have an addictive nature. Thank God I didn't find drugs or something else, but I was taking Advil, you know, 4 Advil 4 times a day for like 20 years trying to serve. That stuff is killing you and you don't know it if you haven't been told. It's not hard stuff, but I found this stuff out the hard way and I want to give back and share this stuff with you. So anyway, I'm ending this up. I'm talking way too long. But I just had to get this off my chest. Mentorship, barefooting, and extreme health. How awesome would it be for you to set a goal, regardless of your age, and say, and I want to make this promise to you. I honestly believe, and maybe I'm too optimistic, but it's only because I've seen it in myself. I honestly believe that even over email or a video, I could help you turn back the clock 10, 15, 20 years. And imagine if your goal was, I want to be in better shape and healthier than I was 20 years ago. Does that sound impossible? I'm a living example of that. Many of you that know me personally, have seen me, know that that's true. My skin even is better than it was 30 years ago. That's crazy. So anyway, any of you guys that want my help, I'm not even sure how to organize this. So just contact me. You guys know I'm easy to find on Facebook, on thefootersedge.com. You can message me, text me off my site. If you have first of all, set a goal, like set an unbelievable goal of being healthier, let's just say 20 years ago. Would that be a good goal that you turn back the clock 20 years and feel better, possibly be leaner, possibly and be in better shape, possibly be a better barefooter than you were 20? Well, for me, I mean, I'm not going to go back to try and to do feet to feet, toe turns, line turns, 1 foot turns and stuff behind the boat tournament ready. You know, that's for me, I've lived that. I'm not going to, I'm still going to have fun with barefooting, but I'm not, my goal isn't to compete at the top level anymore. But your goal, what's your goal? But I think if you, number one, set a goal. Number two, what obstacle is in your way? If there's a health issue, whatever it is, any of the things like I mentioned that are in your way, put that down, contact me, and let me see, because I want to literally jump in, get my hand. I'm not even going to charge for it. You contact me, I'll help you, okay? And I'll figure out how I will, but I'm going to help you. And it may be by email, text. I might decide to make a video, personal one-off for you to help you. And then as I do, I'm going to try and get through like 20 of these and then accumulate this information, not your personal information, but the help, and try and get it organized so I can literally offer something free to people to get them to experience a much better, higher quality life, a better living, better health. It is definitely possible, but you got to, there are certain things that if you don't know them, you simply don't know them. So anyway, I got to end this up. I'm talking too long. God bless you guys. I'm real excited. This is about barefooting, mentorship, extreme health. I'm going to go through, I'll look at your comments and whatever later, but God bless you guys. And if you need my help, contact me and I will help you live the best life you can. Expect a miracle, everybody. God bless you and peace out.